Hey, I'm Dan. It's the first day of the new year and I'm here at the beautiful Bronte Beach in Sydney. Check this out.
The weather is not ideal, but it's still pretty nice.
I've been thinking about what I should do for my first video of 2021, and one thing I always struggle with is writing a script and starting from a blank page. So in this video, I want to show you an app called MindNode that I use to structure my videos and organize my ideas even before I start writing. So let's jump in. Welcome back to my channel, where I want to help people with a creative side hustle find motivation and the right tools to simplify their creative process and get things done. So if you're interested in that, I would love for you to subscribe. But either way, I encourage you to keep going, keep creating, even if you're doing it at a slower pace. Now, as I said in the beginning of the video, I want to show you an app called MindNode, which is a mind mapping app that can help you brainstorm your creative projects. Who's it for? Well, I specifically use it for structuring and brainstorming my YouTube videos before I write the script. But it's really for everyone who wants to organize their ideas and get a bird's eye view before getting into the nitty-gritty of each project. So it could be for content schedules or marketing plans or even the packing list for your next holiday. What I love for my use case is that once I start writing the script, I'm not starting from a blank page because I already have a basic outline of my talking points. For some people, that might even be enough and they can record right away, but I'm not that confident yet. Now, for the purpose of this demonstration, I'm going to use one of my recent videos to show you how I structured it in MindNode. I'm also going to use the desktop version, but I can really recommend the iPad app because it's really fun to use, especially with the scribble feature of the iPad. Let's jump in to MindNode. Okay, so let's do a quick run through in MindNode. So this is the basic interface, and full disclosure, I've only ever used the free version of MindNode, so I won't be explaining all features that are available in the app. And most of them, as you can see up here, are grayed out for me, and also in the side panel here where you can choose your styles, your themes, or can add notes or tags. These are all part of the Plus subscription. Now, the Plus version is $249 monthly or $19.99 if built annually. If you are using it a lot for planning or for presentations, or you need maximum capability for customization for your mind maps, I'd say it's probably worth getting the Plus version. But for me specifically, I only use it for the first brainstorming and initial structure for my videos, so I'm more than happy to just work within what's available in the free version. Okay, so let's start here in the workspace, where we have our first main node, which is sort of the starting point. As I said earlier, I'm going to use an old video as an example, and that was about Adobe Spark, which is an app that helps you create social graphics very easily. So I'm just going to call it Adobe Spark. And then I can create subnotes from here, or what MindNode calls it, children. So this is basically a parent, and then you can create a child and you can create a sibling. Okay, so for this video, I want a video intro. And I want to do a Spark introduction. I want to talk about the interface of the app. Interface. And I also want to give an example. And I want to have an outro. Okay, so if you have something in mind where you don't know yet where that might fit in within your mind map, then you can create another main node just by doing a right click on the workspace. And you, for example, I want to talk about the menu bar of the software. So I have another main node here, which I then can attach to any of those nodes later, but I'm going to show you that in a second. All right, so then you can simply move and rearrange your mind map however you would like. So for example, I would like to have everything on one side. So I just click and drag it over here, and I want it in the right order. So obviously we have the video intro first, and then I want the Spark introduction, the interface, and then I want the example, and then the outro. Okay, so this is my basic order of my talking points, but then I want to add sub points to each of these categories, and then I can just create another child. And for example, I want to say that you can create social graphics fast, and that it's easier than Photoshop. And I want to roll my lazy creator intro. And you can then go on and add more children or more subnotes in here. So it's super simple, and you can continue doing that for each of your talking point. And if you then, for example, realize where you want to attach this other separate note, then you can also just click it and drag it onto where you want to have it. So for example, in this case, I want to put this under the interface section. All right, so if you have a very big mind node or mind map, then you can use one tool which is available in the free editor. For example, I click here on the video intro, and then this becomes available, which is the folding feature. So I can just fold all these nodes away so that they're not visible, if in case you want to have like a very simple overview of your mind map. And then you can unfold them here again. And what you also can do is attaching a subnode or child to a different parent. So for example, if I want to say in the Spark introduction that it's easier than Photoshop, then I can just click and drag it to a different parent, and then it will be attached here. So it's super simple and very intuitive to use, and that's why I never really went into each of the different features, because it's just so intuitive and I just start working in it. And that is really all I'm using it for my initial video brainstorming. From here, I would usually go on and write a full script, or as I said, if an outline is enough for you, you can just use this and start recording, right? But this is really everything I wanted to show you in this little introduction. So let me know in the comments below if you have any specific questions, or if there's anything you specifically want me to cover in MindNode, and I can make a follow-up video. Thanks so much for watching. That's it for this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you're gonna use MindNode, let me know in the comments below for what purpose. I'm really keen to know. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like and a thumbs up down below. It will really help me out. And I'll see you in the next one. Take care.